Canada has just surrendered. Excellent. We'll start sending the rest of our units over. Their divisions, just pop them on a front line in Alaska, so we don't have to worry about it. We have another infantry army. So you, put you up here. Give you a general in Cunningham, and we'll send them over here. We'll, for attacking the USA, what you want to do is make a front line with your good infantry. You want to have your most trained one attack from here. You want to have your other good infantry divisions attack from over here. But they are, they aren't as experienced, so that's why you put them in the place where there's usually less fighting. Your colonial garrisons, just put them on a front line like this, and we'll wait for them to go off over there. These colonial garrisons' main priority is just going to be defending against the United States and just holding this line. And once they abandon this, maybe pushing down the east coast to try and take some of the major cities there. Sometimes France ends up in the war with you in the US for whatever reason, so you might want to train some more infantry units to deal with that later on. Your Air Force, just get as many planes out and split them into the regular groups, fighters of 100 and CAS of 60, and pop them all on your infantry. Armies all supported into America. It is time to unite the Anglosphere. Unite the Anglosphere is nearly done. We'll have a war goal on the USA. Germany's just declared one Czechoslovakia. But the war with France and Little Entente. America's probably going to join the Little Entente. That's normally what happens. So we'll just go from there. So now we've done that. Yeah, the Unite the Anglosphere. Focuses, I'm going to do Imperial Conscription, as a non-core manpower plus 10% is very nice. Civilian factories, just build military factories everywhere. And with your military factories, you can build some more support equipment. Resource-wise, we're lacking a bit of aluminium, doesn't really matter, we can get it back late, we can get some more later. Player one the USA, all Canada to arms. Now, taking out the USA is incredibly easy, because they don't have enough troops to man the front line. We slip around them. So whenever you see a gap in the front lines, just maneuver around it. I'm playing this on 5 speed, and it's completely fine. It's very easy. Research, do what you want. It's 1939 now, so we can get some better industry. And yeah, just micromanage your way in and circle their units. The Americans will convoy raid you here, so make sure you put this to blocked. And just close these pockets. Oh, I have political power, whoops. Yeah, political power, you want to put get the army offensive expert, get the infantry expert. For anything else, doesn't really matter. I'm going to save my political power for if I need it a bit along the line. Like this, draft dodging. Pay rise can do the most expensive option. And, yeah, like I said, closing these pockets. The American troops can't really do against you. Especially with, you have superior numbers. Americans do have a quite beefy divisions, but they are encircled, so they're not that good. No division in the game's good when it's encircled. And you can set your units to attack. Should be able to beat these, relative ease, as you have far more units than them. Working on a rare doctrine. And I think it's time to push over here. We can probably encircle quite a large amount of American units. Wait for these guys to come down. They help with the push. We'll go after France later, so with these infantry divisions, I'm going to prepare a naval invasion. There we are, getting our revenge. There we are, we've gotten our revenge. In these spare dockyards, you can just put on more destroyers. And here's an encirclement we made. Yeah. More encirclements, just walk on their lines. Then once they're encircled, they take supply problems. And they also attack you too, so you just have a very easy time cutting through these American divisions once they're encircled. Casualties are at 100... We have lost 22,000 men. They've lost 150,000 men. That's going to increase quite a bit once we close that pocket. We just jumped up to nearly 200,000. Washington's in sight, let's encircle it. They're not attacking because they don't have a battle plan to do. I have to micromanage this myself, just make sure they mop up all these major cities. Miles does have infantry leader, so we can give him infantry expert. And we can just send the rest of these guys around them. Around a bit. You might, like, not get, like, the odd province like this, but it really doesn't matter. Oh dear, Germany, what have you done? So they're all Czechoslovakia. Oh god, now I'm at war with them too. Alright, okay. Well, that was unexpected. So looks like Germany's gonna, well, it's not going all too well for Germany, so, no, I'm not gonna help them. Right, so what I suggest doing at this point is making some more infantry. I'm going to go up to extensive conscription at this point. I'm going to put my navy out. Liners, United States and France. Alright. I'm going to have to put my navy out on convoy raid, on convoy escort, since they are going to just... they're going to start hitting my convoys, and it's not going to be very nice. Alright, so now I'm fighting a war on... two-ish fronts. Send this naval invasion over. They never defend, what you call it? This port. So you can just walk in relative ease. And send them all over to France. I'm not going to join the Axis. The current state Germany's in. And we'll, yeah, we'll just send our units over. We'll just hold in northern France for the time being. That should remove some pressure off the Germans, and it'll, obviously having Germany still alive will distract France. Our main priority is the US, these encirclements, etc., so just close them. We are gonna win this, don't worry. You might need to be good at micromanaging for you to pull this off. No more if the USA counterattacks, like what they're doing at the north. They don't have enough divisions. They overstretch their lines. They leave to other units getting encircled. Which they really should be trying to keep. Your front lines do get a bit messy, so just reorganize them. Make another offensive line, tell them to attack. I myself have gone on to war economy, and we have got the army regrouping experts. At this point, the US normally just abandons this bit up there, so just don't go on aggressive. Go on... cautious. Oh, good lord, Germany. You're not doing well, are you? Anyway, our main focus is on America. Once we take out America, it should sort out our fuel supply. We can ship all our units back off onto Europe, and we can just go on a massive, nice death march against the French Entente Alliance. In fact, if we just take out France, it should be the war over. We are winning all these naval battles, and we're sinking American and French ships. Running low on fuel, so just make a mad dash. Well, current priority is just to take out the, try and get these American oil fields in, Louisiana and Texas. Once you do get these, the oil states, make sure you set it to forced labor, since you need the resources there, because you want the oil for your fuel to power your navy. Alright, so the US has capitulated, managed to get some divisions down to San Francisco, just rushed it. That's good. All these oil provinces, I'm gonna have to go up to forced labor, since I need the oil. Delete all your, those units, since you don't need them anymore, and your manpower is better off served in some of these infantry divisions. I can send them all off to, France now, and we can send our air force to France, which is the main thing, which is going to help us win. We now have air superiority in France, so we can make some pushes. We should be able to absolutely annihilate these divisions, especially with the Air Force. It is hill, so I'm having a bit of a struggle, but once we start breaking these French divisions, it should just turn into a snowball. Once again, look for encirclements where possible. You might not always be able to encircle them, but because the French divisions, like, pin you and stuff, as you just saw there. But you don't really need to encircle the French. Your divisions are better than them. And you can beat, like I said, like I've said quite a few times now, you can beat the French divisions with relative ease. You might want to capture a few ports, as you are bringing in more units. Like these guys. You just want to basically just flood France with infantry units, and that should help. That should be enough for you to win. We have lots of infantry coming into France now. That supply is going to be a bit horrible, so we're going to get Montgomery because he has Logistics Wizard. This will help us massively. And where we can, we're just going to try and just seize their ports, as it is going to be the only way to get supply over here. We could build ports, but why build them when you can just take them? Did get encircled. Doesn't really matter. We have a Germany seriously attack the Benelux. They're dead. In fact, can they actually do it? Nope. Oh, they can attack. Yeah, they can't. Poland's absolutely annihilating them. In your game, you might have a bit of a Germany might not surrender. Or get overrun like as hard as they did this game. But they're relatively okay to beat if once you have a good enough presence in Europe and you build up, which, to be fair, you've got the entirety of the US and you can have France, so you should be able to win. Put your army on carefully, execute battle plans, or do what you want. You can waste loads of men if you want. Later on, what we can do to secure basically infinite manpower is, now that we've done Imperial conscription, plus 10%, we have war goals on all of India, so we can attack India when we like. Pakistan's also in the war. Somehow. So, okay then. Might be in the peace deal, or might not be, but we'll go and get it back later. Very easy, you can do it very quickly. Might actually free up some gym divisions. I want Germany to fail here, because I'd much rather have Polish-occupied Germany. No. Yeah, Polish-occupied Germany than German-occupied Poland, because Germany is a very tough opponent. Like I said, I preferred it if Germany won this, because I'd rather have been able to show you how to beat Germany, because they don't usually, like, lose. But in a situation like this, if you get this, it's a win for you. Let Germany die. It's the easiest thing to do. So, generally at the end, we have lost 120,000 men, and their losses are far greater than us. Good. Do what you want. Focus-wise, just do whatever you want. Probably not alliance with Germany, considering, like, the current position they're in. So you can do something like air rearmament, I'm gonna do air rearmament. I'll give us some nice bonuses on our planes. We have lots of political power. I suppose we can get Mosley now. And we can just walk to the cities. We have complete air superiority. Got cut off. Yes. Yeah, so, for taking out America, just encircle our units. For taking out France, land a couple infantry divisions in the top of their territory. Remember that they barely ever garrison, Schönberg. So you can land loads of divisions just in their territory. But again, encircled there. Not too big. Don't really mind. We have plenty of divisions. So now we're just going to finish off the French, basically. And that should be everything. Okay, so it's peace deal time. Depending on what Germany takes, it doesn't really matter. It's the current situation, they can't take much. So what you probably want to do is, you want to annex all of the United States, take all of it, annex Pakistan, else take French India too, and just take some, just generally strategic provinces or provinces that have a lot of value like this. I like the amount of chromium on that island, so you might want to take that. Africa doesn't really matter. I mean, there's some stuff. You could take all states in France, or you could make a puppet out of them. The puppet is quite useful, so I'm going to take their colonies. And then I'm gonna puppet the rest. I've given them Algeria because they have some cores up here. I've given them some land around it so that prevents border gore. You can do what you want, but yeah, puppeting them around next to them, it's a they're both good things to do. Take the Philippines, just basically take land in general. We can also take some land off in the Balkans, since there is quite a few resources here. And we can gather oil from Romania. Now, to prevent border gore, what I'm going to do is I'm going to force Jim to take this and I'll make a puppet here, like they usually do. And, oh, you know, forget, I myself am going to take this. It's done, and we now have secured ourselves a lovely bit of land. Now that the war is over, you want to go back to civilian oversight for all your territories, because it will give you more compliance gain, and compliance is way better in the long run rather than forced labor, because you'll eventually get more resources as time goes on. Recruit and deploy. You have plenty of manpower now, and you have plenty of equipment. You can just get train as many divisions as you want. Right, so now would be probably a good time to take out the Germans. So we're gonna set a conquer war goal, 20 days. Actually, I'm gonna let my troops arrive in position first, then I'm gonna send off a war goal. Because they're not a very good position to be fighting back against us. But now that they don't have the Entente to worry about, I think they might gonna start hitting the Polish back soon. So we want to take out Germany now. Greece is asking for Cyprus. No. My divisions are nearly in place, it's time to justify a war goal. You know, justify on Slovenia. Because if I press a state that's near the Polish border, once the Poles take it, I won't be able to... The war goal will cancel. So make sure you take something like Slovenia, which is far away. We should have enough units to take out Germany, I think. And we have spare dockyards to just produce more destroyers. My fleet is split up, so most of them all back up now. And yeah, that's my navy organized. So now we're just waiting for the war goal. Got some more air wings up. We'll have them support our army coming in from the Maginot Line. And obviously we have the Air Force still supporting the other army here. So how's this going to go? We're probably going to make a push through through Hungary and Croatia. I mean, they're Czechoslovakian land. So my main priority is to take Munich, these major cities, so Stuttgart, Vienna, and in Munich. War goal's ready. Let's go. Let's call France into the war. That'll be helpful. And we're gonna try and encircle these divisions, and we'll give the Poles a hand. We could join the Polish faction, but. Maybe. We'll see how it goes. Yeah, their divisions are deorganized. We can just walk into their territory. And once you do encircle them, just make sure you close the close the encirclement. I'd also like to begin our offensive in other places, so I'm going to join Beedzemorts. And I'm gonna join the war, because I wanna attack through Poland and Croatia. Once they are in the war, so we should be at war with them, right? Poland, join wars. What on earth? Why can't we attack? Oh well, whatever. We'll just we'll make do with what we have and just attack through through France. Ah, there we are. Hungary's joined the war now. Hungary's very flat. You should be. They don't have many troops. So you should, yeah, you'll be able to march them quickly. It's also very, Croatia's also very thin, so you can get a couple encirclements too. Four encirclements being closed. Good. Gonna tell these guys to push cautiously, as they probably can win, and it'll get us closer to Vienna. Now I have encircled, Stuttgart, that is one major city down, basically, and there is three more to go. Sorry, two more to go, being Munich. And Vienna. Yeah, so we're just gonna close these encirclements. They are last standing, but I don't really care. Just I myself am gonna force the attack. So Hopefully we should be able to win. Our divisions do seem to be... Well, we seem to be cutting through the gym divisions with relative ease. Like the French divisions, which I'm honestly surprised about, because I usually struggle quite a lot against the Germans. Although, we have made quite good divisions, and hope... I'd like to think it's my, it was my choice to go with, dispersed support that allows us to have the soft attack that we need to do it. Civil war in India, couldn't really care less. I'll just justify a war goal on the winner if I do lose the war goal. And yep, once again, just encircle them. Yeah, we're cutting through Hungary pretty... Yeah, we're just annihilating Hungary, basically. We can work on heavy tanks, since I'd like... I'm going to make my tank visions heavy tanks once I research Churchill, or the Black Prince. And let's just get these infantry division. Let's get these infantry divisions over here just to go and spearhead into Germany. Left that tank undefended. Very poor choice, Germany. And I'm gonna take it. And I'm gonna push through. Gonna push through Croatia too. This will quicken the pace, and it seems to be. We seem to be beating the Germans now in every front, and we're nearly at Munich. There we are, Munich's ours, or it should be, unless they reinforce it. Which they did, doesn't matter, we'll kick them out. They will advance along here. And they surrendered, okay, excellent. You know what, Poland? You can just have Germany. Take the entirety of it. I'm just gonna take some states that will reduce some border gore. So. And yeah, let's give Poland the rest they deserve it. Hopefully they actually annexed that and didn't make a puppet that- Okay, thank god. That is one beautiful Poland. Anyway, so that's- I'm probably gonna call it a video there. We managed to take out the United States, we've puppeted France, and we've taken Germany out of the game, which is a very big thing. You wanna focus on taking out Germany. And I think that is all for now. Actually, I don't like this name placement. Yeah, that's right, Belgium. Try oppressing us through European bureaucracy now. Now that we've secured a nice name placement over Africa, I think I'm gonna call it a day. So anyway, thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. Goodbye.